Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. He's a singer, songwriter, musician, and comedian.
Come on now.
Who's breathing fresh life back into the gospel world.
And with a slew of Billboard-topping singles and hilarious comedic spoofs online, this animated and oh-so-talented artist is knocking out religious convention and making major moves as gospel's renaissance man. Please welcome Jermaine Dolly.
Yay!
That's it right here?
Yes, right here.
Cool.
Purple marks the spot.
All right.
Yes.
Cool.
I like that.
I put lotion on my ankles today.
You did? Yeah, you got your Achilles and everything.
You got it.
It looks nice.
You know what? You just really kind of all over the place in a good way.
Yes.
You know, comedy, gospel, you know. Have you ever had any resistance about all the different aspects of talent that you have and how you bring them all together?
Nice.
Yes. You know, it was discouraging as well. You know, I would think that. For one, I came into the gospel music industry thinking I was going to change gospel music. Like, I'm going to do it. And so I got in front of the doors that matter. And I said, like, who are you? I was like, I'm the pink lick boy that sang gospel music. Like, okay. Y'all know who I am.
Right.
No, we don't know you. So I went back to God and I was like, well, Jesus, like, I keep getting all this pushback. What happened? And I heard him clear as day. He said, assignment over accolades. Ooh. And I knew it was that because I don't talk like that. Accolades, I know what it means, but I don't talk like that, right? So.
But you thought it was a breath mint.
Yeah, like, okay, accolades. He would say, I'll give you an assignment to do, and I'll give you this unique ways of presenting my message, and you're so focused on fitting in with, like, you know, the gospel or getting Grammy and stuff like that, and you're missing my mark. So when I found out what my assignment was and I walked boldly in that, now I'm talking to y'all. So
right. And then there's that.
Come on, somebody.
Yes. Yeah, so you spent 6 years as a background singer for Ty Trippett.
Yeah.
As you look at his career, what can you take from his career that he's mastered and implemented into your own?
His prayer life. I got into the Word because of him, like reading Word. I used to always text him all the time, like, what does this verse mean? What does this verse mean? And I guess he got tired of me, kept texting him. So he bought me a Message Bible for my 25th birthday.
Okay.
And so I got in my Word more, and me getting my Word more, my prayer life more, writing became easier for me, writing gospel music. So just seeing him, he's a genius.
Yeah.
Just a musical genius.
He really is.
But just seeing him pray and, like, reading his Word and how he presents the message of Jesus Christ, I took all that from him, so yeah.
That's good. Mm-hmm. Good stuff.
Now, you have a unique sound.
Okay.
You're up there. Yep. And your finger goes up and your voice goes up.
Yes. They match.
Yes. Your debut album, Dolly, expressed it very well.
Yes.
Congratulations with
Thank
that.
Thank you. God be the glory.
Why do you think that the people resonate so well with you in and outside the church, like through social media and in the church?
Yeah. I'm just being authentically who God called me to be. Mm-hmm. That's it. If you in church, we call it authenticity, right? Mm-hmm. If you look on Instagram, secular world, everybody got the 100 emoji. Mm-hmm. Everybody call themselves a real.
Right. Whatever, everybody 100.
So cool. If you just be authentically who you are, they can't deny that. So, you know, I'm just being authentically who I am. I'm funny. I like to have fun. And I like chicken wing platters in the hood. So
yes.
That's just me.
Why not?
I like that. So,
do you like honey mustard?
I like all that.
Yes.
Come on. Indeed.
Yes. Good stuff. So you talked about your comedy. You know, of course, we went down to your social media to take a look
that's
at one
did.
Of your most popular videos.
Cool.
Let us see that.
That's it.
Oh, Lord. Jesus. Ow! Is there anyone?
This is Mary J. Blige.
Yeah.
If she were a gospel singer.
Yes. She was anointed that night. I don't know what song she was singing. She had to be singing Precious Lord or something.
Like, right.
She wasn't singing, I'm going down. She was singing, like, I need your Lord or something. She was anointed in that video right there.
Well, how do you toe the line, you know, kind of being accepted in this space and not crossing the line with the very, very Christian folk?
Yeah. Again, how me and my team, by any means necessary, what we do before we do anything, we go to Jesus Christ first, right? And God just tell me, be yourself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I know, I present that way because I wanted to show people outside the four walls of the church that you can have fun without compromise. Mm-hmm. So you see that I'm out there, I'm just telling jokes and stuff like that. I don't curse. Mm-hmm. It can still be funny without cursing.
You
know how hard it is to be funny and don't curse?
Yes, but people who are limited, I mean, I'm sorry.
You're fine. I mean, you know.
Limits of vocabulary.
I got you. Cool, I got you.
Speaking of being funny without cursing, you have your own radio show in Indianapolis.
Yes.
You know, Ricky Smiley does a very good job of being funny without cursing.
Yes.
What do you think is more challenging, your music or radio?
Radio.
Yes.
And I say, because I do also a morning show called the Quincy Harris Morning Show in Philly, mm-hmm. as well. So mm-hmm. My gospel radio show, that's pretty easy. But the reason why I say the morning show is hard, gotta wake up every day at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm like, oh man, like I just left the morning show, had to go to New York, then do something else and fly. Like, it's had to do a whole bunch of stuff, but that just waking up every day at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, we know. I did morning radio for 10 years. So I know all about that struggle. Which made it easier for the transition to television, morning television. So you got it. It's the blessing. Then God said,
Come on. She's anointing it. Somebody give her some oil. Put oil right here.
Right here. Speaking of the oil, you're starting a prayer line.
Yes. My next single coming out is called Pull Us Through. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, the song just fixly talks about how, you know, we ask and going to God for, like, just pull us through whatever we got going on. It's not just limited, whatever you may need, financial problems, marriage problems, whatever, children get on your nerve, whatever. It's a prayer line for everybody to call up and say, you know what, I need prayer.
Yeah.
So just whatever your prayer is, we got preachers out there that's going to be on the prayer line praying. I'm going to be on there as well. So, you know, just some, like, just a prayer line. Just call up, get your prayer, and hopefully God will see you through.
Amen.
What you need to get.
Now, what else you got going real quick for the people?
Working on a new album. I'm also doing, it's a guy named, little boy named Mason. He's 2 years old. He's has a kidney. He needs a kidney, right? Mm-hmm. He underwent 10 surgeries.
Mm-hmm.
And
wow.
So my song Waiting, that's out right now. We're doing that initiative for him. It's called Kidney for Mason. If you go to kidneyformason@gmail.com, you can be a donor and help him get a kidney. So we're just pushing that initiative out for him, TV stuff, movies, stuff like that. So God is good.
Amen.
Word up.
I love your energy. You're amazing.
Come on, y'all amazing, man.
Yeah.
Right.
Thank you so much for being here and joining the circle.
Yeah.
You can keep up with all things Jermaine Dolly on his Instagram page. That's hello_Dolly24.
Come on.
Yes. And you can get his number one album, The Dolly Express, on all digital platforms.